We need more men and women like you, civilian volunteers from the mainland to assist you here at Pearl Harbor. We need especially skilled workmen such as electricians, mechanics, shipfitters, draftsmen, volunteers for victory they might be called, because victory is shaped by their hands, as surely it is, as it is being won by the hands of those who man the ships and fire the guns. As the war moved westward, this once advanced bastion of your Navy takes on more and more the aspect of a vast reservoir of ships and facilities, such as we formerly maintained in scattered West Coast harbors. This job of maintaining the fleet in battle is a tremendous task, as you well know. It calls for materials and equipment and manpower in previously unheard of quantities and numbers. The materials and equipment are flowing steadily from the mainland, but we need more civilian manpower to fit our ships for the fight ahead. If you can get this message back to your friends on the mainland, I am sure they will respond patriotically. Side by side with you in the months to come, they will increase the effectiveness of the tremendous effort you have made. The job is not finished. The road to Tokyo is long and arduous, and we must tread it together all the way. On the mainland, our comrades must construct ships. You here must reconstruct ships. We of the fighting units must destroy ships, enemy ships. Construction, reconstruction, destruction. We must continue this cycle of total war until the enemy is overwhelmed by the very preponderance of our labors. Workers of Pearl Harbor and of the mainland, I am very proud of you and of your achievements. Until that day, however far distant, when Japan shall cease to exist as a threat to our civilization, I have but one message. We must all carry on.
Stand and sing the Star Spangled Banner with us, please.
Oh, the ramparts we watch.